Hello everyone, welcome to another video of TOSCA obstacle list. Today we are going to target 810-12, this one extracting text. So let's take a look at the problem statement. Here the problem statement is, please automate a test step taking total amount shown in the success message and enter into the text box. So basically this is the amount 1588.84 needs to be entered here, and that is something which we need to achieve. So let's fire up our scan. We are going to capture both the text box and the text which is appearing. Okay, so I'll capture this and I'll capture this. These two things we need. Now here we see that this amount is going to be dynamic. It is going to change, right? And that is something which we need to extract from the static variable. So everything else seems static. Purchase completed, we charge a total amount of this to your credit card. Okay, now if you take a look at this property, in this inner text property, exact the same text is coming. Okay, if that is not the case, you can probably look for a property whichever is actually taking the exact text. So here, even in the outer text, we are getting the exact thing. So we can use either inner or outer text here. So I'll click on save and I'll close this. Obstacle is 810-12. So I'll just rename this obstacle 810-12. Okay. Now I'll quickly create this test case. So I'll drag and drop into my test case section. Okay. I'll do a F2 and it is 81012. Okay. Now here you see we have to extract only this particular value. Okay. So here, instead of buffering using the buffer part, we can use X buffer. Dynamic buffer comes into picture. So how we can use that is, we can click on this and here you can select inner text, because inner text is containing the exact text like this. So I'll select this and this is the text. So I can copy this exact thing and I can place it here. Okay, now this is something which is changing. Okay, so what you can do is you can remove this amount and instead of this we'll put curly brackets X B, so that means dynamic buffer and then whatever buffer name we want. So let's say we want to name it AMT amount or something like that, and close this. And in the action mode, since it is a buffer, I have to select it as verify here. So there is a quick change here. Whenever you use normal buffer, you have to select the action mode buffer, but whenever you are trying to extract a portion of a text, at that time you have to use action mode verify. So whenever you're using XB, the action mode should be verify. That's the thumb rule. Okay, now we have captured the amount from here. Now we want to enter this value here. Okay, now this is a buffer. So I'll do this capital B and then whatever is the buffer name I have given. So AMT, I'll close and I'll close this. And this is going to be an input. So I'll select input, or by default it is selected input. Now our page is ready. Let's run this and see if it works. So whenever you have to extract a portion of text, you can always use dynamic buffer. So see, it has extracted the text and it has put it there. Okay. This completes the obstacle 81012. See you guys in the next video, in which I'm going to cover another obstacle. If you like it, do like, share and subscribe. Have a great day. Bye-bye.